Adobe Photoshop is a registered trademark of Adobe Systems Incorporated, and I am in no way affiliated with Adobe.
Okay, so I'm going to show you guys how to add the texture to this piece of tape. And in fact, the tape isn't where I want it, so I'm going to move it down just a little bit right there. That looks good. Okay, so now what I'm going to do is I'm going to add, now tape 2 is actually selected, as you can see here. Instead of doing the plastic wrap and the burn and dodge thing to make it look like plastic, we're just going to go ahead and hit filter, texture, and then grain. It's going to bring up this dialog box and it's going to show us our actual piece of tape. As far as intensity goes, you can make it as intense as you want, or you can even change it to a different type of thing, but we don't want it too intense. We want to bring it down, bring the contrast down a little bit, and hit OK. So now we got ourselves a piece of tape down here. It didn't take as much work because this one we had to dodge and burn and do all sorts of stuff to it. This one is fairly easy. Now what you want to do is you want to go to your eraser tool. Make sure that earlier we were using this 45 little paintbrush right here. Make sure that we use 35 on this one because it's opposite. It's pointed the opposite way. So you click on that. You come over here with your eraser tool and you can just make your little cuts. And I'll zoom in for you guys to show you what I'm doing. We're just trying to make the tape look a little realistic here. That looks good. So as you can see, we have this tape right here, which was looking pretty good with the plastic wrap. Or you can do the lazy man's tape, which is just adding grain and that's it. So as you can see, it was fairly simple, fairly easy, and we're basically done with our photograph.